This is the larger V145 and a smaller SH-02. And this is easy to start. This comes with a little plastic box. It has an extra wick, couple of Allen wrenches, and two spare reed valves. And this thing that screws in here that's supposed to look like an exhaust stack. My first recommendation, take this off and leave it in the box. It just gets in the way. You don't need it. I have been known to run things without reading the directions, and that was the case with this. I oiled all the different places that rub or wiggle or turn, and I put a couple of drops of oil in through the intake port, and that was a mistake. This one does not want oil in the cylinder. This is easy to take apart. You rotate this fuel tank all the way over here. You remove this one screw, and then you can wiggle this out, and the piston will just come out of it. Then you can reach inside with a paper towel, a little bit of alcohol, clean it all up. And they tell you to lubricate this with graphite. I didn't have any graphite, so I used molybdenum disulfide, and it's high temperature resistant. This cylinder is just a little bit above room temperature. This will have to run if it gets up to temperature. This is right out of the box. I haven't touched it. This lever goes up and down, and it raises and lowers this reed valve. So that's going up and down every time this thing fires, and that hole in this piece of brass shim stock will eventually start to get larger, possibly egg-shaped, and that will be when you need to replace that piece of shim stock. I have not put any oil in here for that reed valve. I'm running it dry. Try to get up in here and put a little oil on this wrist pin for the connecting rod without getting oil on the inside of the cylinder. A little oil here for the lower end of the connecting rod. A little oil on this cam. This cam follower is running on bearings as well, so it doesn't really need any oil, at least not for a while. And that's it.